In this video, I'm going to show you 7 tips and tricks to get way better results for your prompts. If you're watching this video, I'm assuming you're a very self-driven and motivated person, and you've probably come across a lot of prompting frameworks already. The beauty of these tips and tricks, however, is that they're applicable to pretty much any prompt. So let's jump in. First, and very simply, ask the model to improve your prompt. A lot of times you can spend ages tweaking your prompt to make sure you get exactly what you want. This involves going back and forth with the model in order to get the right answer. But we can actually use ChatGPT to do this for us to save that time. Let's take an example. Say you want to write a blog post about the benefits of drinking water. Your first prompt might be, write a blog on the benefits of drinking water. It'll give you a decent answer, but probably not exactly what you want. Now, instead of spending time fine-tuning the prompt, you can just ask ChatGPT, how would I improve this prompt for a better response? And here's where the magic happens. ChatGPT tells you exactly what it needs to make the perfect response. It might even suggest a new prompt that's ready to tweak for you. And number 2 is an extension of this, but it's for people who mean business. You ask ChatGPT to rate your prompt out of 10. ChatGPT will always give you a response, even if you ask it to improve your prompt. But you're not fully sure whether it's just making marginal improvements or big improvements. Let's take the prompt from the last example. This is what ChatGPT suggested as a prompt. But let's see how good it actually is. Rate this prompt on a scale of 1 to 10. For when you're doing this, it could give you a 3 out of 10, a 6 out of 10, and a 9 out of 10. Whatever it is, just ask ChatGPT, what would it take to make this a 10 out of 10 prompt? And there you go, ChatGPT tells you exactly how to level up your prompt. You could also ask, what other information would it need to make it even better? Number 3, bold all changes. This one is really easy and could save you loads of time when you're revising emails, social media posts, blog posts, whatever it might be. Instead of trying to manually spot all the small changes that ChatGPT has made in a revised draft, just ask ChatGPT to bold all the changes that it makes in the revised version. Let's have a look. Here's the result when ChatGPT gives us an output that doesn't have bold changes. Pretty difficult to see exactly where the changes have been made between the two drafts. Now let's try it by bolding all changes. And there you go. Much clearer what has been changed, and you can decide what stays and what goes. But don't forget to unbold before you actually send it. At number 4, reverse prompting. Reverse prompting is a technique used in AI models where you describe the desired output or goal first and then ask the model to give you the prompt that will get you to that response. So you could have a really good written output that you want to replicate. So for example, it could be a project plan that you really like and you want to replicate this but change it slightly. So you can share this output with ChatGPT and then ask ChatGPT to draft the prompt that would create this. This is also a really good one to use if you want to improve your prompting skills, as you can see exactly what ChatGPT needs to get a good result. And number 5, explain the reasoning. This is another one to ensure you understand what is being suggested. Oftentimes, you can be given a response, and there's certain elements within it that you don't really understand why you're being given it or why it's important. For example, let's say we're sending an email to get a refund from a company. So let's see the response that it gives us. Okay, we can see here that there's some answers. We're not really sure why it's given certain ones over others. So now let's try it with the hack. You just include, before each suggestion, I want you to think before you respond and explain your reasoning for the suggestion. And here you can see the difference. The ideas are a lot clearer, and as a user, I can understand why it's suggesting something and make a decision as to whether I want to include it or not. The sentence also helps guide ChatGPT to give more structured and comprehensive answers. This is kind of an element of chain of thought prompting, and certain models are actually bringing that into their model thinking already. With those models, there may be more comprehension and structure anyway. However, this is still helpful for you to actually understand why it is suggesting something over another, and then make a call from there. Number 6, the feeling you're going for. Sometimes it can be difficult to find the right, words for what you're trying to say. Getting the tone right from a prompt is really important so you don't just sound like any old robot. But a lot of the time, it's actually not easy to find the perfect word for the tone that you're trying to use. Most people only ever think of 2 words, casual and formal, sometimes humorous. But in reality, there are thousands of tones that you could choose from. And lucky for us, these models know them all. So here's what you do. Describe the situation to ChatGPT and ask it what tone would be appropriate to use in this scenario. So for example, let's say I'm a junior member on a marketing team and I'm writing an email to the CMO. I'm asking for a promotion. I want to sound strong and confident, but I don't want to come across as arrogant. So can you suggest what tone the email should take? And boom, you get detailed descriptions of the words that you can use. And last but not least, at number 7, give examples. You'll likely see examples in every prompting framework, and there's a reason for that. It's really helpful, like really helpful. They give the model a clearer picture of what the output should be and also limits the scope in terms of what it shouldn't be. For example, you could prompt it to say that the final output should sound like Leonardo DiCaprio. and that helps show them exactly what good output is.
Ladies and gentlemen.
But also limits the scope so it doesn't look at the other 8 billion people in the world. Some models allow you to link directly to a PDF, to a slideshow, to a website, and this makes it much easier for you to show the example. The clearer you can be with your prompt, the better the output will be. This will save you time having to tweak the prompt and then the output, because ultimately you get a better response earlier on. Keep learning and testing new techniques as prompting best practices evolve every single day. This is my first video, so I really appreciate anyone who has watched this far. If you got value from this, please let me know, and please share it with someone else who may need some help with their prompting. Join me on this journey, and I look forward to seeing you in another video.